Welcome to this new feature of the week video. In the feature of the week video number 13, I have presented how to encode different types of time to event data. This video will now introduce how this data can be modeled with Monolix. Two functions have a key role in time to event analysis, the hazard function and the survival function. The hazard function H is the instantaneous rate of an event given that it has not already occurred. The survival function S is the probability that the event happens after time t. Both are linked by the equation displayed here. The modeling approach used for TTE analysis in Monolix is parametric, which means that the hazard function must be fully specified and can depend on parameters with inter-individual variability estimated with the population approach. To choose a good model, we use the Kaplan-Meier estimate, which gives an idea of the shape of the survival function. This is a non-parametric statistic equal at each time to the fraction of living patients from the dataset. Note that there exist non-parametric or semi-parametric approaches for survival analysis that do not require to estimate the survival function and only use the Kaplan-Meier estimate, but the parametric approach used in Monolix is more powerful if a good model can be found. In particular, parametric models can also easily be used for predictions. To help the user find a good hazard function, common parametric models that describe the various shapes that the survival function can take are already implemented in a TTE models library. The hazard functions and associated survival curves are displayed here. Each model has a scale parameter, called here TE, that characterizes the survival timescale. Most models also have one or several additional parameters that characterize the shape of the survival curve. For example, in the Weibull model, the hazard depends on the parameter TE and P, and the value of P affects the shape of both inflections of the survival curve. The library is documented with a table of typical parameter values for each model. The syntax to define the hazard function in the structural model in Monolix is as displayed here. The hazard function is simply defined in a block equation via an expression that typically depends on the input individual parameters and that can also depend on the time or other variables such as drug concentration or tumor burden, for example. The hazard variable can have any name. Here it is named H. It is then associated with an event in a block definition. These lines define a random variable representing the time of the event, which follows a law of probability, H. The name of the variable here is event, but it can be anything. It will then be used as an output to be matched to the time-to-event data of the dataset. Additional optional arguments allow to define the type of event. For one-off events, the maximal number of events per individual is 1. It is important to indicate it in the max event number argument to speed up calculations. When the events are not exactly observed but interval sensored, it must be specified with event type. An advantage of using parametric models is that there is no restrictions on how the covariates affect the hazard. Like for PK models, standard or complex covariate effects can be implemented in the individual models for parameters, for categorical or continuous covariates. Let's see now an example of TTE model setup in Monolix. I have loaded a dataset containing survival data with exact times for events that record death of patients. The observation type is marked as event. On the plots of observed data, the Kaplan-Meier estimate is displayed. So this is the proportion of surviving patients at each time point. Sensor data are marked as red dots. They represent times at which some individual has left the study before dying. It is possible to split this plot with the covariates. For example, with cell type, which seems to have an effect on survival. Based on the shape of this Kaplan-Meier estimate, an exponential model was chosen from the time-to-event library in the tab Structural Model. The model is displayed here. In the description block, an advice is given for the initialization. A typical value for the parameter TE is the time for which the survival is 0.4. Thus, in the tab Initial Estimate, a relevant value was chosen based on this guideline and on the Kaplan-Meier plot. For the standard deviation of the random effect, I have left the default value of 1, which helps the convergence of the estimation algorithm. Note that with time-to-event data, there is no check initial estimates plot like for continuous data. We can then see the statistical model in Statistical Model and Tasks. For time to event data, there is no observation model. In the individual model, I have kept the default log normal distribution for TE as well as its random effect. Although this is an unusual approach for survival data, in Monolix it is convenient to consider random effects, in particular for scale parameters such as TE, as in frailty models, because it can facilitate convergence. It also allows to use statistical tests to guide the covariate model development. Here, I have already added a covariate effect of cell type on TE. All the results are the same as in the continuous case. For example, I can check that all parameters have been estimated with a reasonable confidence. In the diagnostic plots, there is no individual fits or observation versus predictions. The main diagnostic plot is the VPC. On this plot, the 90% prediction interval for the survival is displayed as a blue area and can be compared to the Kaplan-Meier estimate representing the data. Here the model shows a good predictive power, and it is true as well when splitting by cell type. I could then use this model to simulate new simulations with Simulix. Finally, I will show a quick example where the data is about repeated events, like adverse events for example. In that case, it is useful to represent the data not only with the Kaplan-Meier plot, based on the first event for each individual, but also with the mean number of events per subject. After fitting the model, prediction intervals for these two curves can also be displayed as a VPC. That's it for this video. TTE models can be combined with continuous models, such as joint PK-TTE or joint PK-PD-TTE. It is also possible to combine several types of events, such as death and non-random dropout. We will show examples of these advanced TTE models in another video.